Hello from Shraddha from Love Bites, and today I'm bringing something with the bottle gourd or our Loki, our humble Loki. You know, it is really healthy. I keep trying out different recipes for Loki because we want to consume it a lot more, so you can't just keep eating the same ones. So today is a very interesting one. It is a little long, the process, but believe me, it is worth it in the end. It's also really good for guests when they come in, because it does look very different from your regular Loki ka sabzi which you make at your homes. Do give this a try, guys. Recipes are given in the description box below. Do click on the bell icon for notifications. Thank you, guys. I want to start the preparation for my Loki rings. This comes out really well. So I'm just going to peel it and cut them into rounds and then take out the center portion of the Loki. Okay, that soft portion. Get rid of that. You can use it for your juicing or for your atta and all that. Don't throw it away. And we need just the ring. So don't make it very thin. Decent size rings we'll make out of this. Okay? I've cut them. Just put the knife in. Just go around. That's it. Just make the rings like this. Take hot water in a vessel, tamarind water. Once the water comes to a boil, just put in all your Loki rings inside. Now you need to boil this for 10 minutes, not more. If it gets too soft, you won't be able to do the next round of this work. So it's been 10 minutes and I'm going to just take it all out. See, it's firm but soft. The masala for the Loki rings, I'd boiled some potato and I've mashed it. Now we add in the masala, chaat masala, red chili powder, salt to taste. Just mix it well. The Loki ring and that aloo masala which you had made, and just put it in there. Don't overstuff it. Because then when you do it on the pan, it will all come out. Just like this. So we're going to fill all our Loki rings and keep it aside like this. So I've stuffed all the Loki discs with the aloo ka masala. And now I'm going to heat a tawa and grill these on that. So I've heated a tawa. I'm just putting some clarified butter. Try and make this dish with little ghee, guys, and not oil. Because the flavor it imparts is way better. Now we just cook it. Keep it on a low flame. And how you do your tikki is na, like that you have to cook these. Just flip it. Don't rush through this process. Let all your tikkis get cooked well. Okay guys, your rings, otherwise they'll all disintegrate. Once it's cooked, we take it off and keep it in a plate. Don't dunk this in the gravy way earlier. Just like a half an hour before you serve, do that, because then it'll get too soft and mushy for you. Let's make the gravy for our Loki rings. Take a bit of clarified butter. Once the heats up, to add in some cloves, peppercorns, cinnamon, black cardamoms, green cardamoms. Finally chop some green chilies, I'm adding that. Just a quick saute. And we add in some tomato puree. It's just tomatoes which are blended in the mixie. Once your puree comes to a boil, just add in some water. Now depending on how many discs you've made, you make your gravy accordingly. Because there's nothing much in this gravy, it's just tomato puree, water and the akha masalas and salt to taste. Taste your gravy. If you think it's very very tangy, then add just a hint of Sir Jaggery to balance out the flavors. It's been cooking for some time and I can't get any raw smell. It's quite delicious now. So you guys see how long it takes, and just do this. It's a very watery gravy. It's not a thickened gravy. I'm going to plate it for you guys. I hope you like the recipe. Do like, do subscribe, and keep watching, guys. Thank you.